The Who are a band known for their rock operas. Tommy, Quadrophenia, and even the unreleased Lifehouse are some of their most known works. And while Lifehouse would never be finished by the band, its influence would peek its head onto some of their most successful albums, such as Who's Next and Who Are You. Because of this, Lifehouse usually gets talked about the most when it comes to Who projects that never materialize. But there has always been one other that has fascinated me. Before Quadrophenia, Townshend had an idea for an autobiographical album telling the story of the band's first 10 years. From early on, Townshend had very personal lyrics, and starting with Lifehouse, he began to write more and more about music.
The song is over. It's all behind me. I should have known it. She tried to find me. I'm singing this note 'cause it fits in well with the chords I'm playing. I can't pretend there's any meaning hidden in the things I'm saying, but I'm in tune, right in tune. I'm in tune, and I'm gonna tune.
The best of the first attempt of Lifehouse would find its way onto Who's Next. But what Lifehouse is to Who's Next, Rock is Dead, Long Live Rock is to Quadrophenia. That said, there's quite a bit of overlap between the four projects. Joined Together, for instance, was written for Lifehouse, then repurposed for Rock is Dead, but was eventually released as a standalone single that helped bridge the gap between Who's Next and Quadrophenia. Lifehouse, as you may know, was to be a sci-fi rock opera slash concert film that is famously hard to describe because no one really understands what was being attempted other than Pete Townshend. One constant in the multiple revisions was the idea that a concert and music would bring people together. That idea morphed into Who's Next, which doesn't have an overarching theme unless you know exactly what you're looking for. But 10 years into the Who's career, Townshend began to look back. The songs that were previously written about a world-changing rock concert that brought together humanity and resulted in the rapture now would be repurposed to be about The Who. Unlike Tommy, which had characters and a story, Rock is Dead, Long Live Rock was to be more of a collection of songs with a loose theme. The idea, as we know it, would have been more of a standard concept album than rock opera per se. The Who would even do a more concise retelling of their career in Success Stories.
Saturday night, got a gig with the band, playing the electric guitar. Someday I'm gonna make it, gonna be a super duper star. Get a big flashy car, and a house for my mom.
Love Rain Over Me and Is It In My Head are on the proposed track list, but neither are distinctly about The Who.
Just how serious the band was about this being their next album is up for debate. From all that I've read, like most Who ideas, it was more of a Townshend idea than the group as a whole. It's doubtful it was given serious consideration to be the follow-up to Who's Next before Quadrophenia took place and before the rest of the band even became involved, but just how far it got remains to be seen. What we do know is by the time Townshend wrote The Punk and the Godfather, about a young mod who goes and sees The Who, or at the very least the mod band, the protagonist began to switch from The Who to one of their mod fans in their early days.
Rock. The effects of Long Live Rock, Rock is Dead, and the more reflective eye of Townshend will be seen for albums to come. As previously stated, Entwistle wrote Success Story on an album full of Townshend grappling with becoming an aging rock star and the issues that come with it. Lifehouse's influence would be all over Who Are You, and the band commissioned a documentary about themselves with The Kids Are Alright. While Lifehouse is always mentioned as the great lost work of The Who, this loose concept of an album shows just how fluid The Who's post-Tommy concepts were, blending into each other, but ultimately resulting in some amazing music and albums.